Okay? When you are using object-oriented programming, you will define, you will design objects. That means that your main way to decompose the software is to define several objects. But then sometimes, as you know, if you're familiar to object orientation, your program then will have the different object collaborate with this other to perform some task. So tasks are cross-cutting the dimension of the object. You may have several objects, but then you may have some tasks. And to see them, okay, you can't see them explicitly. There is a little piece here in this class, a little piece in this class, and so on. Okay? The idea is to be able to also define some task that cross-cuts the object dimension in some places, separate places.
Satırların altına koyarsınız. O zaman bu cross chart dediğimiz şu var. Bunlarda özel alakalar bulan bir şey özellikle masada ne için? Kaysi ki hızını masadan kaytaşlar bir şey işletir işi. Şu işletir işini biz bunlarda kısım şu objektlerle takatı veririz. Çünkü her bir kısım değil, her bir objekt değil, özellik nasıl bir adı cevap veriyorlar, responsibility veriyorlar. Güzel.
So the main idea is to be able to reason, to think, following not only one axis for decomposing software, but at least two, maybe three. Okay. You want to be able to decompose software with regard with two different directions, two dimensions. Okay?
Two dimensions?
Two axes. Classes, aspects.
Aspects.
Okay.
This cooperation is aspects.
You can call them tasks if you want so far.
Tasks.
Yeah.
Aspects.
Objects, tasks, for example. Okay.
Objects and tasks. Yani horizontalımız task dediğimiz yani zadaçalar, vertikalımız object dediğimiz. Yani şu iki ölçülü narsanı biz demek aspect.
Okay, let's tell it another way. You have the main decomposition way, okay, to get a module.
Module.
So you will get the modules, and then you will get the cross-cutting modules, transversal to the basic modules.
Okay. Demek, biz modüllerini koyarız ve modüllerini orasındaki bana şu transversalını, eski o zaman alakanı biz zadaç ederiz. Şimdi zadaç içilendi, modüllerimiz alakasında. Doğru mu? Çünkü buna sanırım hızma dediğimiz, task dediğimiz, buna sanırım modül. Yani satırım task, buna modül var. Şu iki ölçeğini ben sanırım açayım.
Okay, this is basic idea. From that time, I already told it, the paper was really great because many people that were doing some research work very close to this ideas, okay, say, okay, I'm okay with you, I'm really related to you. And then, very quickly, a community of researchers gather together and they have called their research topic advanced separation of concerns.
Advanced separation of?
Concerns.
Concerns, okay. Then, go. Aspect oriented programming kaydedenden ki kısım demek yok zarif normal geçer demek kök olumlar noktada taşındılar bugün ve bunu demek advanced separation of concerns de became such a AC or C de bulunuyor.
Okay, and this community of researchers started to work together more and more often, more and more closely, okay? First, it happened in some workshops that were related to IKU or OPSLA, for example. And in 2002, they even created their own conference for aspect-oriented software development. Okay, so the AOSD conference series were started at that time, okay?
Aspect-oriented software development was started in this time.
2002.
2002. They were sure. Bunlardan ki onlar işte bir de programlardan başladılar. Yani müzik işlerinde. Neticelerde şu iki tecrübeler de bir çarpı vurdular. Opslardan buna bir yoklar. Bu okulda 2002 yılda Aspect Oriental Sıfırı Dördüm'ün öz işini başladı. Yani önce şu niçin koyuldu.
This conference series is still alive, and she's now has been renamed Modularity since 2011 or something like this. I guess. Okay. So it's if you look for IOSD conference, you won't find much more on the internet, but you should look for Modularity conference. And Modularity is a new name of the name as the same. Yes, the same conference series. Okay, so let's get back now to the principle of separation of concepts, because it is very important to understand spectral-oriented programming. And actually, this is not a new thing. Even in 1997, it was not new. Because in 1974 already, okay, there were some people that were telling a lot about separating concern, okay? It was Dijkstra. You know Dijkstra? He's a very famous researcher in computer science. He did a lot of work in algorithm and also in system, okay? And it is directly taken out of a paper of Dijkstra here. So it is what I sometimes call the separation of concern, okay? This is what I mean by focusing one's attention upon some aspects. It does not mean that ignoring other aspects. It is just doing justice to the fact that from this aspect's point of view, the other is really irrelevant. Okay. So the idea is what some other researcher here have later called the functional decomposition. Okay. For example, if you want to decompose regarding the functional axis. Okay? The idea is when you pay attention to this part of the software, you don't have to pay attention to the rest. Because it's not interesting just for caring for this part. Okay? So this is the main principle of separation of concern. It is not true. It already was stated out and loud in 1974.
Demek bir asosyal videoya böyle bir baş.
Programming is from 1993, so it is aspect-oriented programming, here, okay? It was some work that was done by another researcher and professor, and from the IBM Research Center. And after IOSC, it becomes a multi-dimensional separation of concerns. They gave them, they gave to this work a new name, but it's almost the same. And they did their own extension of the programming Java programming language, which is called IPERG. Okay. The principle for this approach was to okay. I am caring, for example, as a software for managing a company. Okay. So I will do a design of the software for all what concerns. Paying the salaries and managing the salaries. Okay, so I will end up with some object-oriented design. I have an inheritance hierarchy of classes, okay, which is perfectly fitted for salary management. Okay, on the other hand, I will take care of the producting system. Okay,
what's
producting system? To produce. Goods, for example. Suppose it is a factory, or the management of all the mechanisms that will produce the goods. Okay, and okay, I will end up with another inheritance hierarchy with some classes in it. Okay, which is perfectly designed for managing the producing system. Okay, then I will take care of the storage. I will, once again, have another inheritance hierarchy that is perfectly designed for the storage management. Then I will take care of the marketing, okay? And I will end up with another inheritance hierarchy, okay? Which is perfectly designed for the marketing. Of course, because all these four hierarchies are related to the same company, okay? You will find a lot of common point in those four different inheritance hierarchy, in those four different object-oriented design.
Same tasks.
Not exactly, no. Not the same task. But most of the time you will find the same classes.
Same classes.
Same classes, but described differently.
Ah, described differently in these four.
In these four different inheritance hierarchy. So there will be some common points, but there will be also some differences.
Okay.
Okay. For example, let's take the example of a product. Okay? A product that is made by the company. In the production system, it will be described as what are these components, what kind of task should I shift to produce the product, and so on and so on. Okay?
Shift to another place?
Sorry? In the inheritance hierarchy of the production system. Mm-hmm. Okay? Then, for the same product, if I look now at the inheritance hierarchy, the object-oriented design for the storage, I will mainly find the weight of the product, its dimensions. If I have to store it in a dry place or not, if I can store it outside or not, or something like that, where it will be stored and so on. Okay? If now I take a look at the object-oriented design for the marketing, regarding the product, I will see the price of the product. How many money should the company gain from selling and things like that. Okay? So you will find some common parts, but some differences, a lot of differences between the four hierarchies. Okay? And the idea then is, okay, when I focus on salary management, I focus only on this design. Producing system, only this design. Storage on this design, marketing on this design, okay? And then I want to have a whole object-oriented design that can do anything. Because I don't want to have a separate software for handling the salaries, and okay? I want to be able to think at each of them separately, but I want only one system, because only
integrated system.
Yes, exactly. And for this, they invented some rules, composition rules. Okay. So sometimes you will merge together. Okay. Sometimes you can say that this will take precedence on the other design. Okay. And you will put some rules in your different design, and you will project on this design to end up with only one design at the end. That will be the running design for the software. Okay.
So many things.
Okay. Each of the different design are called subjects. Okay. So you can say that you have subject for salary management, subject for product system, for subject for training and so on. Okay. And then sometimes when you want to get some efficient, effective design, okay, that you can run, that you can execute, you will try to project all this design on one final software. Okay? And to do this, they invented what they call composition rules.
Composition rules is instrument for?
Yes.
For project. So
for composition rules, you may say that I will merge, I will add from here for here. Sometimes you will say that you will only take this and forget about this, okay? So it's I won't tell it in details, okay? But the basic idea was this, okay?
Teşekkürler. Demek bir yerde parastralı sınıfta bir görsel bir görsel yapmayı yaptı. Demek bizde ne var bu sistemden bir işte doğru mu? Aslında şu sistemden bir işte bir işte var sistemden bir gerçek yaptı ki. Birinci demek oylik. Oylik demek. Dizayn ile yapsanız ikinci demek. Siz işler çıkarsın, dizayn ile yapsanız üçüncüsü demek siz. Склад дизайн клеса, тоа ти мислам се на се позори дизайн клеса. Не мора да е нешто позори што е микс на тоа. Шуми микс на овој ми клас на овој, има шерда, шунда е бар инструменти, инструмент од околи се да бидат прилаштри, битта проективна, проективна битта го радиме. Наша композиција е тоа прилаштри што е.
If you are interested in it, you have to take a look at it. And then we have the composition filters. Composition filters was made by Dutch people in Netherlands. Okay, University of Twente is in Netherlands. It was made by Wilmer Taxis mainly, and all this team. And composition filters. Okay, let me explain this very briefly. You know the picture of invoking a method on some objects is very often it is pictured as sending a message to the object. Okay? You know why we have taken this picture of sending a message or instead of just say I'm calling a method? You know what? You know why? Sorry? It is a question. For them.
Okay. I don't understand.
Okay.
For object oriented is sending message from.
Okay. Most of in the first object oriented language, people always take a picture, are picturing.
Picturing.
They are picturing the fact of invoking a method, of calling a method. They are picturing it through message sending. We send a message to the object. We are not invoking the method, we are sending a message to the object to invoke the method. Have you already heard of this?
Sending the message?
Sending a message to an object.
It is calling method.
Yes, but why we say sending a message?
Why we say sending a message?
Yes, this is the question.
Ah.
Why,
why
in object-oriented approach people use to say sending a message to an object
to
instead of just calling the method. You know why?
No. Sending a message and calling method is the same.
It's the same. Okay. You know structured programming. You know structured programming.
So send off to Brahmin. So
you never say, I'm sending you message.
No, no.
You just say, I am calling this brochure. Yeah. Okay? And why, when it comes to object orientation, we take this picture, we are picturing you, we are imagining that we are sending an message to an object. Okay. This is the question.
Okay, Dima, method man, okay, procedure and chat with me, object, Хабар uzatışga almış. Ama bu demek adikler diğerini nasıl? Şuraya karar. Picture'in bir yana da şöyle var. Şuraya karar. Okay.
What was the question? Why is this picture? No,
you might have.
Why do you say I'm sending a message instead of just telling I'm calling a method?
Because
normalde olan sağ ol veriyordu ki ne oldu ki bizler calling method demeyemizu sending message demeyiz. Ne oldu ki calling method demeyiz şu fayda bir çay sporlar yani sağ ol farklı bir madında.
Çünkü olmayın ki funksiyonel program araçları şu anda başlatır gelmiyor çünkü de azrat şu için bunları biliyorlar.
Mağdur. Kaybı
zmeni. Somewhere told that for
I can say it in English.
Before the object-oriented language, in structural language, call it this same calling method.
Yes. Procedure call.
Could be different.
When it comes to object orientation, why are we saying that we send a message? It's not to make a difference. Mm-hmm. it's not the right answer. Yes, it's better. It's not exactly that, but it's closer to what I would like you to remark. Okay, but great. Not exactly. Okay, I will tell it. The idea, when you call a procedure, it means that the procedure is just called to be executed. In functional programming, you would say, I will apply a function. So you are the ruler, you are the king, you can do what you want with the function and with the procedures. Okay? In object-oriented programming, we prefer to say, I'm sending a message, because actually, we want to take the picture that the object may accept the message or refuse the message. Mm-hmm. It is to emphasize encapsulation and access to the method and access to the attributes, to the fields. Okay? It is to emphasize on it. Of course, everything is written and the programmer is still the only master. Okay. But the idea is that when at the place where the object is defined, in the class that defines the object, okay, that you can decide which kind of message will accept and which kind of message will refuse.
Call method degan bo'lsa, siz bochyosiz. Siz nimani xohlasangiz qilasiz. Siz arabni bajaring, jeni bajaring emas, bizlar ishladi. Bu protsedura chaqirdingiz, bu protsedura ishladi. Ishlamasa bo'lmaydi. Chunki siz qo'lingizda. Lekin obyektni chaqirayotgan paytda sanat boshlagan, demak bu bo'lib bu nima deydi? Alohida deydilar. U qabul qilishi mumkin u xabarni. Akas kılışın bu kavramlar. Bu barcası işe numaralı şu adiyetini apisat duyguyan klasına konu koydu. Siz de neydi? Siz gece konu koydu. Bir cevap haber verirse kabul kıladı. Eğer konu koydu, buzuk adam oldu haber verirse olma kıladı. Kaytarlar haberinizde olmaydı haberinizde. Şu üçün bir yerde sending message diye. Bak, calling...
İlk başta hiç yerli olmazsa gücünü inkapsülasyonu.
İnkapsülasyonu buzmaydı.
Yes, this is to emphasize the situation, exactly. Okay, so let's get back to composition filters now. Following this picture of message sending, the composition filters are filters that are put between the object and the outside. And the messages
interface
will have to get through these filters to reach the object.
Interface rules?
Yes. That's a yes, but I don't want to use the term interface anymore because it has different meanings in Java and Graphite and so on. It is filters, they name it filters. Okay, so it is something that is put between the object here,
okay,
and the message that want to get to the object. So the messages have to get through the composition filters to get to the object. So it is filters because it will filter the message. It is composition because you may put several filters on top of each other. Okay? And in some filter you may, for example, reject a message. So you won't let it pass. You may let it pass, but you will transform the values of the arguments, for example. So it is a method call. You will change the arguments of the method call. You may take this message and send another message instead. Okay? You can do a lot of things.
During the composition filter.
In the filter.
In the filter.
Okay? So you have the outside, the message is sent. The message will get through the first filter, it may be changed, okay, and to the another filter, and so on and so on, and finally the object will get one message only for the closest filter.
Without changing of semantics of message.
It may change the semantics of the message. It's not hard for that, but it may. There is no restriction on it. But you may do a lot of things.
Demek yerde composition filter deganda osha demak obyekt qabul qiladi-ku, osha xabarni qabul qilishi davomida o'tadigan etap nimalar, filtrlar. Demak filtrni filtrdan o'tmasligi mumkin, o'tishi mumkin, filtrdan o'tishi mumkin. U almashtirilishi mumkin, semantikasini almashtirmasdan yoki qaytishi mumkin. Tushunarlimi? Kam bir filtrni ustida ikkinchi filtr qurilishi mumkin, uchinchi filtr qurilishi mumkin. Filtrlarda yana filtrlar tashkil qilishi mumkin, shuning uchun composition filter.
Okay, so why does it rely to why is it related to AOSC, AESOC, advanced separation of concern? Because you have the decomposition axis of the object, the classes, and then you have the filters, another axis for decomposing software, and then you can just compose the filters as you want on top of the object. So you have two ways, two different directions in which you can with regard to which you may even pose on the square. Okay?
No, with that, what was A?
Advanced separation of concern.
Advanced separation of concern. Bir de bu kişi işlemedi. Yani şehirde filtre işlemedi. Bir durumdan bir şey alakalı özetiş için. Şu alakası bu dumanı. Demek composition filtrelerden demek advanced separated concern. Also concern.
Okay. And then we also invited to cite all the work on role-oriented programming. So this work that began the first paper of this most important work in 1919, okay? But there are several research work here, not only the one for the only one team, one research team. You have the one from Christensen, for example, a lot of work on it, but several other persons. The idea of role-oriented programming is that you may, of course, define classes, that is object, but you will also define roles. And roles may be endorsed, or put on by objects. Okay, and some object may endorse several roles. Maybe several times the same row, okay? And this way you have also two axes, two directions to decompose the software, the objects themselves and the rows. And by putting several rows on some object, you will change them also.
In one axis,
rows, and the other axis, the object.
Ровно общаться, да? Внимание. И то, где я говорю, что ровно надо больше руки, думаю, что ровно надо притягивать на шнур, каким человеком на шнур нас. А когда я там был сад, я говорю, как бы ровно приедет то ближе, это кирпич.
Okay. So, and I will speak later in this set of slides of aspect G, much more extensively, okay, and we speak about aspects. So aspects and subject are quite the same. I mean, it is the main dimension for thinking about software. Composition features and role-oriented programming is a little bit different. The idea is that a set of several roles will give you one dimension for looking at the software to compose a whole point of view. I will explain that on the next slide more precisely. Not that one, the next one. Okay, what are the motivations for event separation of concern? We are here interested mainly in two problems, and these two problems are very closely related to each other. The first problem is, so the problems are both caused by code cross-cutting. The idea is that you have defined classes and there are still some concerns that cross-cut, that go across all the classes, okay, and that is then present in several classes or not. Okay. These two problems, more specifically, are code tangling. That is to say that a modus will gather code that is relevant to several cross-cutting concerns. Okay? You will, in some software, you have a class, I don't know, let's say a class person, for example. Okay? And you will have part of the definition of the person that are only relevant for the studying concern or for the financial concern or for the, I don't know, the physical advantage and so on concern, okay? And in the same class, you will find code that is relevant to several cross-cutting concerns, okay?
Модуль, который заменитель сахарайды, бірнешті консерварный, бірнешті қарашыларын, қарсики. Бірнешті, мысал келтірсен, масаданды оданды классы, одан классы, масаданды оқытыш процессы, чүнкі та бір хыл кодлар бар, кемісі масаданды ма, финансы, бұта томаны бар, масаданды, мауқшынсы, медицинсы томандан қарайды бар. Бұлар модуль дегенде, сұрайды, сұрайды, қамасы. In module, this browser,
yes,
this all concerns.
Because I wanted a module to plainly define what is a person. Mm-hmm. I decomposed the software that way. So that means that all what is cross-cutting will be present in the person. Mm-hmm. Okay? So problem is that I can't focus very precisely, very easily, on only the part of the person that is directly relevant to that concern. Mm-hmm. I have to encompass the whole definition of the person at a whole. Okay.
Sure, okay.
Okay.
İkinci
muamelesi de değil yani. Birisi bu problem.
Yes, kontaktayım.
Birincisinin önce şanssızlığı olmaz mı? Kodlar bir şanssızlığı.
Kod mu?
Kod, çarpıyaşlık. Çarpıyaşlık bir şanssızlığı için. Birinci muamelesi.
Ama bana şu, demek bu kod ne? Muammol yaptık bu.
Birincisi de yanlışı şanssızlığı
da sınırlı. Demek bu kod ne değil mi? Şanssızlığı diyemez.
Çarpıyaşlık, çarpıyaşlık. Çünkü Tarkov'da Alıp çok olmak yanında. Başka bir şey yok. Türkiye ile bir yıkık koyuyor. Çok kolay oldu. Abi tane bir yıkık koyuyor. Fırlaştı.
Bu kadar bir şey yok. Sonunda biraz how translate code tiny? It is not, I am not sure, yes?
It is, I can't translate it in Uzbek. I may translate it in French, but I don't know it can
help. It is not
it is like this.
Ah, no, Spanish.
Sure. Yes. It's mixed. Not exactly spaghetti, but well.
Mixed thought. Difficulty to
hold like women when they wake up in the morning.
Şunları, demek bu işansızlık değilmez. Kodlarını bir taraştaki kodla, ikinci taraştaki kodla araştırmış.
It's difficult to separate what is pertinent to some concept to the rest sometimes. Okay, and then you have a very closely related problem because the two problems are together. Okay, it is code scattering. And code scattering means that if you have to care of some concern, the code of this concern is scattered among several classes. For example, if I care of the study concern, I will get some part in the person because it can be student or teacher. I will have some part in the class because you need classrooms. I will have some part in the schedule because you need a schedule for classes and so on and so on. And if I want to care about all what is relevant to the study concern, managing the studies, say, okay, I have to look at several classes.
You are here to.
Yes, into several separate files, separate classes.
Okay, and from another hand, one class gathers
all what is
concerns.
Yes, all what is relevant to several concerns.
İki tamamlanarak bir tada bir neşte tuttu, deki bir tada concerni, bir tada karşını, deki bir tada işte tamamın kısırları bir neşte bastı. İkinci problemi bir neşte bastı. Birinci problemi bir tane arsa, bir neşte arsanın turşu. İkinci problemi ise bir tane arsanın bir neşte arsa turşu. Biraz bunu ben yoldaş problemi.
Okay, scattering and hard
hopping. Hard hopping,
okay, so the idea is to define transverse some transverse concern, cross-cutting concern, what we will call cross-cutting concerns, in cross-cutting software components. So we should have components for basic decomposition axis, okay, and then components also for cross-cutting concern. So the idea we will have components modules for what is called cross-cutting, okay, and we make all these the aspects because it is what will happen, okay. We will call this cross-cutting concern when there are defined in some into so separate software components, we will call them aspects. And then we will weave. So weave is that, you know, with yes, but with the machine, you know? Like you do the, not the carpet, but let's say the Suzani?
Suzani,
for example. Suzani, you do some weaving, okay, at that time. And you will weave the aspects, okay, with the other software components. So if you are using object orientation, you will weave the aspects with classes. If you are using functional programming as a basis, you will weave the aspects with functions. That is the idea, the general idea. Okay.
Okay.
So we will define all what is cross-cutting concern into separate software components that we call the aspects.
Okay.
Okay. then we will weave these components with the basic software components, that is to say, classes, if you are using object oriented programs.
Și am primit de la TPI, de la TPI, asociat cu ceva iguria, de la TPI, de componente de și în cea, ISP, așa, aspect nu zice dolar, aspect nu zice dolar din care, dintre componente în afară, dar o component, de la o calibră, de la mâns, adică, în timpul programului, ISP, zice așa, în mădăim să se iubi din nou,
Topeș.
Topeș, Topeș,
Okay.
So here's an example taken from Eclipse, and the tool in Eclipse that allows you to use respectively very easily HTTP and to visualize effectively the cross cutting of the aspects and the classes. Okay. Here you have vertically classes. This is an example that is given with it is a spaceship space war game. Okay, you have a spaceship fighting together. Okay.
Ships fighting together.
Yeah, it is some game. Some game. And you have several classes. So you won't see much here. This is, for example, class for timer. Okay, this is a bullet that you send to missile. You have the spaceship here, I think. Here should be gate control. And you have several display classes. It should be display bullet, display. Okay. You display the spaceship, display the bullet, display the, and so on. Okay. And those are the classes. So the length of the class is directly related to the number of lines to define the path. Number of lines. So the shorter, the less lines.
Definition size.
Yeah, the definition size. Okay. And then you have some dashes in the classes here. And these dashes.
Colored lines.
Colored lines, exactly. These are the aspects. You have the aspects here, and they define an aspect for coordinating, an aspect for displaying, an aspect that ensures that ship is alive to control the game, an aspect for registration, for starting the game, certainly, an aspect for painting the space object, and so on. And you can see that, for example, for the display aspect, you have a big part of this cross-cutting concept here in game, but also here, and here in this class, and also here. So this aspect, the code of this aspect, when you suppose that it has all been weaved already, okay? So you define your class, you define your aspects, and suppose that you already did the wheel, all together. Okay? The result is that we have some part of the aspect of space here, here, and here. For the coordination, it is this part, but here, here, here, here, here, okay?
Okay, in, you can get it. How we will define aspect?
In separate files.
In separate files, what name is this files?
Aspect.
Aspect.
Yeah. Okay. We will see that later with the aspect here precise.
Okay.
But here you have the idea of the cross-cutting things, the cross-cutting phenomenon.
Okay.
Okay. So this is the result. You may look at it. This is the result after weaving.
After weaving.
After weaving. This means you can look at this. Okay, the weaving gives me this, but what it gives you, the weaving, is just an object-oriented code. No more aspect-oriented code. it is just a particular input that you made to run with a Java virtual machine. Okay? So that is to say, if you hadn't designed the software with AspoG anyway, you will have in this class some kind that is directly relevant to display. Here also. Okay? Okay, let me show you directly.
Class.
Yes, but
classes. And what is colored lines? It is
different aspects, different cross-cutting.
I know, but it is not.
It is like you should think ahead as if you were looking at your class definition. So there are lines and words. Lines and words.
Aspect Kılıç'a bulunuz. Bir kavramı kısımınızda.
Ceray'a.
Şimdi Ceray'a mesela bu ne ya? Aslında Tomo'nuz. Tomo. Cihadımız. Cihadımız. Şu cihattan kararımız dediğimiz, bu cihattan kararımız. Yani şu cihat degen narsa, cihat degen bir köşe aspekt değil mi? Rusça kalmaz mı?
Susi kolla desen bir adlı.
Ha?
Susi kolla desen bir adlı.
Yok. Aspekt dedi, cihat geti olur o kere düş, aspekt desen bir adlı. Gül şey kalmaz, bir Rusça kalmaz, bir güzel aspekt. Aspekt degen adlı şu aspektler kadar. Gel bana şey yapacaktım. Yemek aspektler yaptı. Problemin ki aspekt, yemek bir de tanımızda aspekt, ikinci de olur. Klasın içinde numaralar var, aspektler. Ede slavuzda küçümüzler olsa ki klas türü hamar arsan bu sıçı olmalı. Lekin biz bu on durun arsan kılışımız için bunu biz içine yetişimiz var. İki de problemi bu. Bunu sileye bana bir reçelikte bunlar biz görgemiz. Bir de tam oraya karışıyor. Bana bu metodik bir metodik ki anı bir anı bir sınır karışım gerek bir değişim kılış için. İkinci bir işin kılış için ise bu metodik oluşum gerek ki bu metodik ki bu metodik. Yani bunlar metodikler içine tutar da doğru mu kışırız? Doğru diyor mu?
Cerrahimiz kadar karıştı.
Yani,
onunla karıştı.
Cerrahim dese gel.
Mustafa Nazar.
Mustafa Nazar, cihat, aspekt. Ana şimdi olsa bir yerde ajratın kuşanın bir tomasını makul yaptı. Bitti nasıl diye oldu. Yani biz kuşanı kozumanınca, neticede biz ne kuramız? Şart olup çıkardık da bana bu bildi, numa, diskoya aslında. Şart olup display aspekt hocam. Boşka boşka klasa da hocam. Lekin bir takım koysanız. Display aspekt. Yani biz aspekt bu işe yoğunlaşıp da demek ki biz doyma bizge izmeniyle nöme kadar aspekta kadar doğru mu? Zataçan özgertir şuna da kadar aspekta kadar doğru mu? Bana bu klasını özgertir demeydik bizge doğru mu? Ana bu iş anlamına bir iş gerek değil. Doğru mu yok? O şeyimiz, ahtarşımız gerek. Bu bir değil ki nasıl bir cevap verir, nasıl bir cevap verir. Ama bundan bu özgürtüsü göre, bundan bunu, bundan bu.
Ve o bir ondan bu da başka obyektlere nispeten karıştırıyor bu da. Mesela bu obyekt ise buna karasaya bu başka şey mi çıktı? Şunayı nasıl olur?
Yani bitti sınıfta sizler diyorsunuz. Evet. Bitti derse gel siz karayetken paytızda yani siz klaslar yoksa stilin, mesela diyor ki bizim bu iş sistemimiz. Bunu da ki, mesela bir işli kılıç gerek siz gayet alın, ana bu işli kılıç. Kesin sonu ilk tarafı içinden okutarak, stilin modüler. Ana modülde işleşim gerek, bu modülde, bu modülde, bu modülde. Haber de olsun, hangisinin canına bir tecrübe çıkardı, siz pozisyonu özgartırsınız, peki siz de özgartışlarız, sırrı hava klasların çözün aksini topu. Bu bana, bu kadar sıkıntı. Bak, bu benim, bu benim. Siz de özünüz değil, yuvarlasınız bu. Sistemayız. Siz de öz
karıştırıyor.
Yani siz önünde sınıf özgertiriş isterler, küçük yaşıyor. Şu önünde sınıf özgertiriş isterler, artıda size kırık kılmaysınız. Aspekt ne olacağız ki aspekt takmaz. Aspekt özgertiriş kılmaz, şu önünde sınıf özgertiriş. O zaman şu
mantığı.
I make, for example,
can see that some classes are not affected at all. Some other classes, like for example, here this class, it will be games and presentation. Okay, has only a few. You can see here a few impacts. Okay, and for other class here, for example, I don't know if you see it. The color is not very, but from here to here, you have a lot of impacts here.
In one class.
In one class,
but.
And this is the same aspect. And you can see also that, for example, this class here is impacted by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, at least 6 or 7 aspects. So, because of the contrast, you can see it, but there are differences in the pinks and purple here. And on my computer, I can see better. There are 7 aspects that impact this class, okay? And at different points. And you can see that this project, this package, has been extensively reworked since the last version I showed you on PowerPoint. Okay? Because there are a lot of impacts, so they put as much as possible into the aspects. Okay? And if I remove all the colored rectangles, it will be what is very common to what is the essence of the object.
Okay, this colored rectangles shows to us this is belongs to this aspect.
Exactly. So there are two ways to understand this kind of visualization. Suppose we don't know at all about aspects. Okay? We want to design, so to end up with some object-oriented design. We will end up like this, with these classes. Okay? But if we look further, we will remark that in these classes, this part is pertinent to some aspect, whereas this part is pertinent to some other aspect. Whereas the white parts are pertinent to every aspect.
And white part is below the
aspect. It is what is directly defined in the class, actually. So when you say, for example, point as a mixer and line, it's independent of any aspect.
So white
part means no impact of the aspect. So it means that this part of the definition of subject relevant for any prospective concept.
For any?
Yes. Okay. So you may say, if I did a simple object-oriented design at first, I will end up with this. And afterwards, I will look at my thoughts and so, okay, I will take, you know, the big pen lab for overline. So I will take an overline. And then we go to my definition and we say, this is synchronization, okay. Here also, okay. Then I change the color. And this is from, okay. And if I did the object oriented design, I will do it like this. But what is shown here is the result after the wheeling.
After we
aspects put together with the classes. This is the result of it. Okay? And what is great is that, I have to show you the aspect again. What is great is that I was able to define all of these things separately. Okay? And all of these aspects are separate concepts. Means all of this will cross-cut the passive, okay? And but it is separate here. So I may take care of typing separately for all of the rest of the
body. Can you do it now?
No, but because I don't know this project. But I'll show you an our example later.
Okay. I hope you will see this aspects codes together
yeah.
something
yes. No,
something we know.
Yes.
Something we know. we will see and we will change and this effect will be in that process.
I'm not sure I think yes.
This is aspects, yes?
Yes,
for now. Okay. So in some way I can see aspect
related to aspect together. I can see and I can change. Yes.
Okay.
Because it is separately defined.
Okay.
And you may modify separately the classes and the aspects.
And all parts put that in his place.
Yes. That's okay.
Here, two classes.
Two classes are not impacted.
Not impacted. At all.
No. I almost done this introduction. Okay. So here is... So here is another diagram to show how it works. So we have here the classes. Let's say class C1, C2, C3, C4, C5. Okay. And then I will be able to define several aspects. Okay. I will have the aspect A1, A2, A3, A4. Okay. I may have some aspects that will only impact a few classes. For example, the aspect A3 will impact only one class, the class C4. I may have some aspects that will impact that implies a lot of classes. For example, A2, it will impact each classes. Okay, so the circle means it will impact this class. Okay?
It means
will impact.
Will impact.
A2 will impact C1. Will impact C2 and C3.
And I want to black class. What is black class?
Just classes that are not impacted by aspects.
Not those.
I may have class C6 here.
Uh-huh.
And with no cycle.
No cycle. Yes, with no cycle.
Okay.
Okay.
And here it is what we call joint points. Points at which the aspects may impact the class. Okay? And actually, in a circle, I may have several joint points, several ways, several places where the aspect may impact the class. Okay? So this is just for popular memories. And this is the main idea.
Okay.
You may define your software in classes. You may then define aspects for cross-cutting concern. These aspects may impact all the classes or only a few. And thereafter, you will be able to weave the classes together. Okay? And that means that we will get something like this, with only the classes, you mean? And the classes with all the aspects embedded in it.
Okay?
Okay, want to translate this or
it is time for the break?
Yes, I think so. Because it's the right time to see.
Yani aspect dediğim nasıl olur? Klas kısmı da yaşlı şuna sana. Lekin şu klasına göre biz de bir neşte aspekt alıyoruz. Yani bir neşte zarmetten de jareon, hükümetten de bir şey karşı. Yok, yok da.